Hello, I'm Terry Muir, and today I want to show you around Sustainable Kashi. I want to show you some of the different regenerative systems we use here every day, including organic gardening, composting, and off-grid living. Here in the compost zone, we compost for over 80 people. Let me show you how we're doing it. Here we gather all the leaves from the property to act as our carbon source for our compost. We then take all the food scraps from our kitchens and put them into these 3x3 movable bins. We cover them with the leaves and let them sit for about 3 months, making beautiful, rich compost. Here in the EcoVillage, we use composting toilets. This low-cost, very easy-to-use system turns all of our human waste into valuable fertilizer. This unit has a really amazing urine diverter that takes all the urine away from the solid waste and puts it into a trench filled with biochar, which is basically activated charcoal. That soaks up the urine, stops any smell, and captures all that nitrogen. We then add that biochar into our compost pile, in which we add to our gardens later. To use the toilet, we simply make our deposit, add a couple of handfuls of leaves, and then we let that sit for up to 1 year. Here in the EcoVillage, whenever we add a new system, we try and connect it to other systems, so the waste from the system feeds something else. For example, here's our outdoor shower, and all the water from the outdoor shower runs down this pipe and into our banana circle. That actually waters our banana circle every time we take a shower. Here we are at our downdraft solar dehydrator. Here we dehydrate moringa, tulsi, fruits, all so we can preserve them or make them into teas and spices. The downdraft model is really important here in Florida because we have so much humidity. If we were to just put a bunch of these plants into a hot box, they would mold up and they would rot. So here, with the downdraft, the hot air collects in this front area, which is really shallow and the bottom is painted black. That pushes all the hot air up, and as it rises, it pushes through these screen trays, heating them up and adding air circulation. So all that moisture gets pushed through the trays and out this chimney out the back, which goes right back into the air. In our kitchen, we use a biodigester in order to create the fuel that we cook on. We do this by using the food scraps that we would have taken to the compost, and instead we put them into this anaerobic digesting chamber that catches the methane gas and sends it back into the kitchen to create a clean burning fuel. This system also creates a beautiful nitrogen-rich effluent that we use in the gardens for a fertilizer. Welcome to the Hanuman Garden. This is an 18-bed demonstration garden that we use to teach students how to plant and harvest organically to build soil structure and create nutritious, delicious food. We're excited to tie as many systems together here in the Sustainable Kashi Gardens. This 55-gallon drum is filled with the effluent from the biodigester that we learned about earlier. This effluent is mixed with water and makes a high nitrogen fertilizer for our vegetables. We apply this liquid fertilizer about every 2 weeks to give our plants an extra boost. I'm always planting the next crop right after I harvest the previous. Now I'm going to plant some sunflowers where I just pulled up these cut flowers from before. I like to use a seed planter to really speed up the planting. One of the reasons I started growing my own food is because I wanted to connect with my medicine. We're standing here in the tulsi garden, in which we grow perennial tulsi. We make tea out of this, which helps reduce stress and really tastes delicious. The systems that we use to make energy in the cabins are also very simple and very easy to install. We use solar-powered systems consisting of four parts. We have solar panels for collecting the sun's energy. We have charge controllers that control how much energy goes into our batteries. We have batteries which store the energy when the sun's not shining. And we have inverters that convert the sun's energy into energy that all of our appliances can use. We've built the energy and the water systems in the cabins very simply using items you can find anywhere, We wanted to be able to show people that you can do this yourself with items you probably already have at home. The rainwater system simply collects water off the roof, runs into this rain gutter, down the rain chain, and into a 50-gallon drum. This water we take and put into a Berkey system, which filters the water in which we use for drinking. We're very proud of the three tiny homes in our off-grid EcoVillage. These buildings give a hands-on demonstration of what it's like to live using these regenerative technologies. We believe that as you immerse yourself in nature, it's easier to see the simplicity that these systems can offer. Each one of these tiny homes has its own regenerative water and energy systems, and they all have their own story to tell. Our office building, which was donated by Rob Greenfield, is set up as a perfect demonstration site for anyone to come in and really touch each one of these systems. The other two tiny homes are set up very simply with only a bed and a desk on the inside. We believe that this provides a perfect setting for people to study and dive deeper into their relationship with this beautiful world of nature all around us. There are many ways to get involved here at Kashi, one of which is our volunteer program, where you can come and stay with us in our off-grid EcoVillage and learn how to grow your own food while living sustainably in our regenerative community. Sustainable Kashi has many offerings, from farm-to-table dinners, online classes and webinars, and hands-on immersion opportunities, including permaculture design courses, weekend retreats, and a variety of sustainable living classes. We are located on 80 acres of protective native Florida land next to the wild 30,000-acre St. Sebastian River Nature Preserve. It's so easy to live like this. I started about 20 years ago. Basically, I was a broke hippie trying to buy organic food, and I couldn't afford it. So I decided to plant my own organic food. I planted a bed of lettuce with a friend, and then I planted another garden with another friend, and then I had two gardens and two friends. And now I live in an intentional community surrounded by people who love organic food, love to learn from each other, and really value community.